Hello and welcome to YouTube Developers Live. We have an exciting show for you today. We'll talk about developer experience and getting started with the YouTube API. But first, let me introduce my esteemed guest today. In the studio, I have Fred Sauer. How are you doing, Fred?
Hi, how are you, Jörg? Thanks for having me today.
Doing good. Today is my birthday, so this is a very special show for me.
Excellent.
And then Daryl Chang, how are you doing, Daryl?
Hi, good. How are you?
I'm doing good. Daryl, as you might remember, has guest starred in one of our shows a few weeks ago, live from New York. He's our intern, going back to Stanford very soon. But before we let you go, Daryl, we need to talk about your awesome project. So my name is Jarek Wilkiewicz. I work for YouTube Developer Relations. Let's talk about the motivation of this project. And maybe starting with you, Fred, I know you've been busy working on Cloud Playground. Tell us what it is and what problem are you trying to solve?
So I've been a developer advocate on the cloud platform for many years now. And consistently, the feedback I get from developers who have been on the platform building applications, that they're very happy with the features and the capability and just how easy it is to kind of manage their applications at scale. But it turns out when developers first get started, there's an initial hurdle of just getting Hello World up and running. When all the tools are unfamiliar, when you're working on a new platform, that's when it's really the hardest. And if you liken it to a relationship, it seemed like we were asking developers to invest heavily first, download an SDK, download a runtime, get your laptop set up, and then you can try it out and fall in love. Mm-hmm. And I thought, maybe let's turn that around. Let's go on a date first. Let's try it out, get a chance to fall in love, and then do the rest of the stuff. So the Cloud Playground is a way to start building applications, small Hello World guestbook type applications, right from your web browser. Zero downloads, zero installs. Just get going.
And fall in love at the first sight.
Absolutely.
This is great. Well, Daryl, I know you've been working with that. And I was thinking perhaps instead of talking about the project, maybe you could give us a quick demo of what it does.
Yeah, sure. So this summer, I've been working on a Cloud Playground embed for the developer site. So why don't we go to the developer site right now? So on the developer site, we have static code samples that demonstrate how to use different APIs. And with the Cloud Playground embed, now you can interact with these different code samples and run and modify the code within your browser. For example, right now, we're on the YouTube Data API for Python for App Engine. And you can see that this code sample for search by keyword has a button in the top right corner. If you click this Run Modify button, you'll be able to interact with the sample code. It loads the Cloud Playground embed, and you can see that there's a code editor and an output container. Now, in order to view the correct output, you need to set up a project and get your API access key. So click this link here and follow the instructions. Why don't we roll the video to see how to do that?
In this segment, we'll be talking about how to obtain a developer key to make YouTube API calls and run the sample code. To do this, we'll need a registered Google account. The first thing we want to do is browse at a Google API console. We can find this at code.google.com/apis/console. Or we can just search for Google API console in our favorite search engine. We'll need to create a project the first time we open the site. Projects are a grouping of APIs, and it may make sense for us to create different projects for every new application that we write. For running the sample code, we only need one project and one set of API keys. After we enable our project, we'll need to enable some services. Let's click through to the Services menu if we're not already on this page, and scroll down. We'll want to enable the YouTube Data API and the YouTube Analytics API first. Let's toggle the YouTube Data API from off to on. The very first time we do this, we'll be presented with the Terms of Service. We want to read Terms of Service and accept if we want to be able to use the API. Now when we scroll down, we'll see that the YouTube Data API has been accepted and enabled. We'll click on to also enable the YouTube Analytics API. The Search by Topic code sample requires the use of the Freebase API, so we need to enable that as well. There's a separate Terms of Service that we'll need to read and accept. Once this is done, we'll need to access our API keys. We can do this by clicking API access in a navigation menu. There are two types of API access, simple and authorized. If all we want to do is search for videos, channels, and playlists, all we need is simple API access. The key is already provided to us in our project.
All right, so going back now to the Cloud Playground embed, all we need to do is to copy and paste the API access key to where it says replace me. Now that we've done that, we can make the API call. And all we have to do is click the Run button to see the output.
So what's happening right now is the code that you modified locally within the editor gets sent over to the app engine, executed, and then you see the results, right? And this is happening against the API key that you have configured in the previous step.
Right, exactly. So you can see the output here, which is an iframe of the deployed app engine site. And we can see that we get results for the query term dog using the search by keyword API. Now, let's say that you want to make a modification to the code. Mm-hmm. All you have to do is make the modification in the code editor. So Yarik, let's say you want to change the query term dog to cat instead. All you have to do is make the modification and press the play button. And again, this is redeploying the site. And now we should see the results for the keyword cat instead of dog. And as we can see here, videos for cat. Let's say that you don't like the modifications you made and you want to go back to the original sample code that we had on the site. All we have to do is click the Reset Project button. And it'll reset the project to the original sample code.
So if I made a mistake because I don't know Python well, I can easily recover by hitting Reset.
Exactly. So any mistakes you make, anything you don't like, just hit the Reset Project button and you'll be fine.
Great.
And let's say you do like the modifications you made and you want to continue developing locally. Mm-hmm. All you have to do is click the zip button to download the project as a zip file. So as we can see here, I've gotten the project as a zip file and I can continue developing locally. But you have to remember that you have to download the App Engine SDK and any other necessary files in order to run it. So that's a quick demo of what the Cloud Playground can do on the dev site. And I hope that helps developers get started with API calls more easily.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much for running the demo. I would like to talk a little bit more about what's under the hood. And Fred, I know you've been working a lot on this project. Tell us a little bit more what happens. How does this all work?
Well, the Cloud Playground, as Daryl was showing us, sort of consists of two parts. The top half of the Cloud Playground is a sort of a mini development environment. Mm-hmm. You can edit text files. There's actually a way to manipulate projects. There's nothing really special about but this application. It's just a way of maintaining files in the cloud. They actually are maintained in the App Engine data store. And every project has a unique set of files, which are the source code, the sample code that you're looking at. What's really interesting is the bottom half of the user interface, which is an iframe that's embedded into the main user interface. And when you press the blue play button, what we do is we go out to App Engine, and based on the URL, there's a project ID in the URL. And we use that to grab all the files that you've been modifying and keeping up to date, and we eval them at runtime. And the server, you know, figures out the results. In this case, the sample code is calling a YouTube API, so we call the actual production YouTube APIs, and we get the results set back, and we send it back to the client. And so what we have is sort of an App Engine app running on top of an App Engine app. Mm-hmm. It's a little bit maybe recursive and sometimes messes with your mind a little bit.
Pretty meta, indeed.
But luckily, when you use the Cloud Playground, you don't have to think about this. You can think about it as you're just writing some code on App Engine that runs. Mm-hmm. And then when you're ready to go to the full experience, when kind of you think, yeah, this date went pretty well, and now I want to take this relationship with App Engine a step further, you can download the SDK and the Python runtime if you don't have one installed. You can run this locally, and then you can deploy it to production, and you have a real production app. And then whenever you like, you can come back to the playground and maybe try something else out.
Great. Well, this is really exciting. So, Daryl, I know you need to go back to school, but I was going to ask you, what are the types of things you think would be worthwhile to add? What are the potential enhancements that we could make to this project?
Yeah, so one of the things we were going to work on is to add a wizard to the dev site page. Mm-hmm. So for example, in the example I just showed, you had to go to the API console and set your project there. But we want developers to be able to set up their project within the page itself. So what I want to do is set up some sort of wizard in the site to reduce the amount of navigation developers mm-hmm. have to do.
Cool. Anything, Fred, on your side that you're willing to share with our audience? Any? I know we typically don't talk about roadmap, but what are the types of things that kind of keep you awake at night, and as far as new enhancements that you could add, and you are not right now?
That's a good question. So there's a lot of things I'd love to do. A lot of people ask for various features. The good news is the Cloud Playground is an open source project. Mm-hmm. So if you log into the Cloud Playground at cloud-playground.appspot.com, and you scroll down to the bottom right, there's a little link to the Git repo. You can clone a copy and you know, add features yourself or mm-hmm. contribute them back, obviously. That's what open source is about. I think the biggest feature on the roadmap for me would be somehow add support for other languages. Mm-hmm. Then we started out with Python 2.7 just because it was easy. You can do eval on the server. Maybe we want to do Java or Go or PHP. You know, Java and Go, they require sort of a compile step. So you have to take your source, compile it, and then execute it. Mm-hmm. So that adds a little bit of complexity. Just a little bit. So maybe we could take Compute Engine instances and combine them with kind of the App Engine front end and mm-hmm. the user interface, and provide support for N languages, and then just keep kind of cranking N up. But ultimately, I want to see sort of a very smooth transition from, hey, we met, let's go on a date, let's have a little bit of longer relationship, and hopefully this is a long-lasting relationship with the platform. Mm-hmm. But on each step, hopefully it's a very smooth kind of incremental, and you can wade into the water as gradually or as quickly as you would like. And when you're ready, you can always take the next step. That's
great.
Where we're headed.
That all sounds very exciting. Well, thank you very much for joining our show today. I think this is a really great addition to our developer documentation. It's going to make the 5-minute user experience on our site much better. I would like to invite you all that are watching to send us your feedback. If there are features or any other feedback you have about this functionality, please reach out to us. We're on Google+, on Twitter. And then last but not least, if we'd like to help us take this to the next level, we are hiring. Check out developers.google.com/jobs for information about the positions that we have open. Well, until then, see you next time live on YouTube Developers Live. Thank you very much. Bye.
And happy birthday, Yark.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.